And today we are breaking down YNT, Down for the Count. Bitch, sorry I was gone so long, but I'm back. Stay with me. Thank you. Bye.
Welcome back, everybody, to Chaz's Rock Record Review. Blah, 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 blah. I'm already messing up because it's been a while, but I'm back. And summer was busy. Things happen. But I've, in time, learned to do some new technical stuff. And we're going to try this a whole different way this time around. And hopefully you guys are still with me. I wasn't gaining some traction, but, you know, shit happens. But here I am today to talk about YNT. Down for the Count. Now, there's nothing special about my version of this album. There we go. Cool cover. Kind of like, I don't know, Dracula trying to take a soul, the soul of a robot, and the robot is definitely female, but I don't think robots have souls. So it's interesting. The back cover, the boys and all their 80s glory. Yes, so YNT is a band that I am not uber familiar with. This album, of course, has the hit Summertime Girls, and everyone's familiar with that. But and if not, you probably are, you just don't know, but you'll hear it later. My only memories of YNT in my life, there was a guy at a bar I went to who was super into them and used to expel their virtues all the time. And I just wasn't having it at that point in my life. So like I said, never a small YNT fan, honestly. Like, they're not like strangers to me, but there could be a lot more. I could have done a lot more to listen to them in my life. So I was happy kind of when this came up to give this a chance. And I know this is kind of a controversial album for them because of their musical shift, because this album started to get them along the paths more of, you know, Bon Jovi and stuff like that. So first we will get a breakdown of the album. And here we go with some new, I'm doing some things, guys. All right. Down for the Count is the seventh studio album by the American heavy metal band YNT, released in 1985 by A&M Records. The album marks the band's change to a lighter sound to find success in the hair metal scene. It contains the band's biggest hit, Summertime Girls, which charted at 55 on the Billboard Hot 100. The song had initially appeared as the only studio track on the band's live album, Open Fire, released earlier that year. The album itself peaked at number 91 on the Billboard 200, and on December 14th, 1985, it was the last album featuring the original lineup of Dave Menichetti, Alves, Kenny Moore, and Hayes, as Hayes left the band the following year. The reception, the All Music Review, Eduardo Rivadavia, there we go, gave the album 2 stars out of 5 and criticized the band for joining the perm-haired masses, then issuing like dandruff out of the California dust to redefine the meaning of the word dumb. Ouch, bruh, that's a little rough, Rivadavia, Eduardo, that's a little rough, brother. All tracks are written by YNT except where indicated. And you see down here, track 8, Your Mama Don't Dance, Kenny Loggins and Jim Messina, which, you know, was famously covered by, in a more popular sense, by a more popular band from the times, Poison. The band is Dave Menichetti, Joey Alves, Phil Kennemore, Leonard Hayes. And if I'm saying any of this wrong, guys, tough. I'm just learning here. Look at additional musicians. You know, you got Claude Schnell. He played keyboards, I believe, for Dio at one point. Yeah, Magic, rough cut Dio in the last in line. So he's a guy. He's a player. And as they said, Billboard 200, they went to 91. Summertime Girls hit 55 on the Billboard 100 and 16 on the mainstream rock. And you got Summertime Girls and the opposite, All American Boy, 48 on the mainstream rock. So So there is your overview of this album, and we're going to get into the review now and go track by track. And I just want you guys to give me a little leeway here. This is new for me, the way I'm recording this, and you know, I'm not sure how the sound is going to come out, and if it sounds great, disregard this, and if it sounds bad, I'll have it fixed by next week. So let's go ahead and get right in to the album review process of Down for the Count by YNT. Sorry, here, hang on, it's coming. Sorry, I'm doing stuff. It's coming. Okay, hold up. Okay, all right, now I should be able to share with you guys. There it is. Sorry. Okay, here we go. Down for the Count by YNT. And it is playing. You can't hear it probably yet, but I promise you that it's playing. Just listen closely. Pretty hot coming in. It's a good hot intro. I like it. It's a good opener. Good little pre-chorus. It's a catchy ass chorus. All right, so we got the gist of In the Name of Rock and Roll. So let's go back to their second single on this album, which would be All American Boy. Oh, this is 80s. Chevy with four on the floor. Last facts, cheetah slicks, 454. Girls on the phone, girls at my door. Just not the worst. Coming back for more. I'm just too late, but it's fun, love it, all American boy. Oh, okay, all right. I'm just too late, but it's fun, love it, all American okay. boy. Well, it's definitely of the times, guys, so... we're just going to move on to Anytime at All. What did I do? Did I pause it? My bad. Let's start it over. Let's get that again. God damn it, I keep pausing. Sorry. It's so 80s, it's ridiculous. I don't mind this. I do like this. This is a catchy melody he's got going on. Big pre-chorus, I like it. You bet the big chorus, come on. Come on. Let it tell me it all. Okay, I jumped the gun. I like this one. I'll tell you what, I like this one a lot so far, and Dave Menichetti's voice is very it's very, like, you can pick Dave Menichetti's voice out in a crowd, I think. Just the few times that I, the few songs that I know, and just hearing this, you know, off the rip there, like, he's definitely got a distinct voice. So let's go on to the next track, which is Anything for Money. It's a nice little rock and roll. It's got a good driving beat. It's a good heavy metal song, guys. I like this song. I like this one a lot, actually. This is a good, heavy, heavy song. Moving on to Face Like an Angel. Uh-oh, do we have a ballad? It smells like a ballad. I do like ballads, guys. Very nice. Like this. She's got a face like an angel, but the devil's inside of the game. She's got a face like an angel, but the devil's inside of the game. Oh, I love that chorus. But the devil's inside of... Oh, what a chorus. Good job, Dave Menichetti. All right, here it is. Wow! Yeah, Dave Menichetti. Y&T trying to be Bon Jovi. Hey, at the rhyme. Hey. Oh, yeah, I just want to watch the girls go by. It's canceled. It's corny, but it's fun, guys. Ride that bell, baby. The big hook. I know this one. I was just giving it some layers. She's hot. All right. Hopefully I didn't ruin that for you with the singing. It's Summertime Girls. I mean, it's great. It's a great 80s cheese ball song. And that's what you want. Summertime Girls is perfect. Let's go to Looks Like Trouble. Ooh. Yeah, baby. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. You feel that, girl. Yeah, I'm going to take these pants off, girl. Ow! Oh! Nasty. I like this. What you got, Dave? Sitting here waiting for the next sucker punch. Damn. Gave him my Ferrari. A woman with a brain can be a dangerous thing. Spin me like a top, like a puppet on a string. I can't help myself. Oh, I'm just a toy on the shelf. Oh, just a fool in love. It's a long pre-chorus. I like his voice in this thing. Well, it looks like trouble. It looks like trouble. Okay. Kind of lost me a little on this. Alright, he lost me a little on that. Just, it's definitely, he was definitely writing that to be an arena filler, and maybe it was, but I do like this verse. It's got a cool riff, and he sounds great. Okay, here we go. Here's a cover. Your mama don't listen, your daddy don't rock and roll. Poisons is already better, I can tell you. Your mama don't dance, your daddy don't rock and roll. Woo! When evening rolls around and it's time to go to town, where you go to rock and roll. The Simmons drum pad. Listen, the old folks say that you gotta educate by tail. It's not that different. Honestly, it's not that different. Actually, this was before Poisons, wasn't it? I think it was. To be honest, yeah. It's not bad. A little lead here. Alright. This is boring blues rock. I like Poison's versions. This isn't too bad, but I hate boring blues rock. Don't tell me what to wear. Oh, this is pure teen angst lyrics. Threw me out. Oh yeah, you tell him. Said what I was wearing, we're bound to make him shout. I said, get out of my face, don't tell me how to look. Go back to your algebra and your basic algebra. He said basic. Don't tell me, don't tell me, don't tell me what to wear. Don't tell me, don't tell me, don't tell me. You squat. Wow, I think I wrote these lyrics when I was like 16, Dave Menichetti. You don't tell me what to wear. Don't tell me how to cut my hair. Come on. I mean, I guess if that's what you're going for, was the teenagers, you know, market. Like, it could work. You called him a square. That was funny. All right, moving on to Hands of Time. Hand jobs of time. I'm still laughing. They called the guy a square. Oh. I feel like it's almost Christmas. Ooh. This is tasty, I gotta say. Oh, beautiful. That was beautiful. I gotta pause that for a second, go back. That second pass. Oh my God, that was gorgeous. Hey, we got to go back and just listen to that. That was beautiful. This first one's good. This second one. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. That was great. Don't be afraid. I like it, guys. Does he do? I just don't hear if he does that. This again. Don't do it again. Okay. I said don't do it again, even though it's beautiful. I just thought it might have been more impactful that first time, but like, I'm not going to tell Dave Menichetti how to write a song. He's, you know, he's pretty good at it. I got to say, that was great. Let's go to the next song, Can't Find Me. Oh, no, we're done. That moved on to Night Ranger. So we are done with that album. So let's get back to full screen here. And finish her off. Finish him. Sorry, guys. I'm still learning how to do this. Okay. So I listened to this a lot, you know, when I was first given it. And then I, you know, haven't really delved in a while. And listening to this fresh like that was an experience. Like, so this might be the new way we're going forward. I pick the song. I pick the album. I find the record. Hang it up there just to show you I have it. Not that it matters. And then maybe I listen to it live first and give you my reactions then. I don't know. We'll see how it goes going forward, because if I do it that way, I don't get to the guitar solos and stuff. So we might, you know what? No, we're going to stick to do it the way we do it, where I listen to it and then we break it down this way. But either way, like this is fun. I'm happy that I'm back. Like, to do this, I'm sorry I was gone for so long, guys. And, but all in all, sorry, I forgot to put this album in the book. So all in all, you know, I don't love this album. I don't hate this album by any means. I kind of lost track of where my ratings were before, but this is better than some of the stuff we listened to. Like, it's better than the Cheap Trick, album. That's for sure. You know, I'm going to give this one a 7. This is a 7. You know, could be a 6.5, but we'll go 7. I'm going to be fair. Let's knock it back down to 6. It's not, I don't know if I'm going to run and listen to it a lot, but I don't hate it, you know? So we're going to go 6. I know I'm all over the place, but let's check out our new album that we're going to do on random. All right, let's get it random. Okay. All right, we're delving back into a famous band, even more famous. Yes, even more famous than Y&T. We got Metallica, Hardwired to Self-Destruct. I'm familiar with this album. This album I listened to a lot when it came out. I bought the vinyl. It was playing a lot on Sirius XM, I remember, and stuff. Released 18, November 18th, 2016, and the album prices range from $11 to $49, and it is a double vinyl. So, so you got your homework, Hardwired to Self-Destruct by Metallica. I know I've been gone, but you might be getting some extra content because it's Christmas time, so keep your eyes out and your ears out for that. Thank you, everybody, for joining me on Chaz's Rock Record Review. It's good to be back. If I lost some of you guys in the meantime, I'm so sorry. I apologize, but I'm going to be back now, and we're going to be having some more fun reviews and some more fun content. So thanks for checking it out, guys. Until then, we will see you next time. Peace.